Hello and welcome to God's Word for today. My name is Brenda Gross. It's good to be with you. Good to be in the house of the Lord. And I'd like to welcome everyone by the way of radio and by the way of TV. And wish you a wonderful day in the Lord today, because this is a day that the Lord's made for us to rejoice and to be glad in it. Praise God. And you know what? We can rejoice and we can be glad in the day that the Lord has made for us. When you get out of bed, you know what? You can determine if you're going to have a good day or a bad day. You say, well, how in the world do you do that? By your attitude. By your attitude. You know what? As the old saying is, your attitude determines your altitude. Your attitude determines your altitude. Your attitude determines how good you will feel and just what will bring joy to your day. And you know what? That's God's Word. That is God's Word. If you get out of bed thanking God, Lord, I thank you that this is a day that you've made for me to rejoice. And I praise you and I give you glory and I give you honor. And Lord, you are my God. And I thank you, Lord, you're the King of my life. You are my High Priest, Jesus, and I love you. And your Word is real to me and you're real to me. And I want to walk in your Word and do the things that please you today. And do what you've told me in your Word to do. And just be thankful. And you know what? In a few minutes, your day is going to be a whole lot better than it would be if you were to get out of bed and say, oh, Lord, it's Monday again. Have to go to work. It's Sunday. Have to go to church. Well, then have to come back and cook something to eat. Have to go to the grocery store. Well, then I have to go wash my car, something. You know what? You're going to have a bad day. And everything you do is not going to go right. You know what? Because you've determined when you got out of bed, the first few words you say determines how your day is going to be. Say, Lord, I thank you for a stress-free, peaceful, easy day in Jesus' name. I thank you for a stress-free, peaceful, easy day. Hallelujah. You know, just start praising God. Have a song on your heart. A good song. I don't mean one of these so-called gospel songs that full of doubt and unbelief and dread and fear and just a weary pilgrim, you know, barely getting along and, you know, no. Praise God. We're the righteousness in Him, set apart, made holy by the blood of the Lamb. Jesus paid the price on the cross for us so that we could be more than conquerors, and we are more than conquerors through Christ. If God be for us, who can be against us? And the Bible says in Romans 8, what do you say to these things? What do you say to these things? What things? What do you say to tribulation and persecution and famine and distress? Nay, the Bible says, Romans 8, chapter 8. Nay, in all these things we're more than conquerors. Or no. Praise God. Christ always calls us to triumph. He always causes us to triumph. In any situation we're in, any circumstance that comes out my way, praise God, Christ always causes me to triumph. Praise the Lord. Well, you know what? Some people might say, well, now, you know, things happen and stuff like that. Yes, they do. Things happen. Things happen to good people. But you know what? Whatever you say and however you act in the circumstances is going to depend on the outcome. I heard my husband say that. I thought that was good. I said, that'll preach. Whatever the attitude you take, whatever you say, and whatever you say about the Word of God determines the outcome of that circumstance that you're in. You know, yes, bad circumstances come up sometimes. But you know what? When you look back on God's Word and say, Lord, you promised me that I was more than a conqueror. You said you'd never leave me and forsake. Never forsake me. So I know that you're right there, right with me wherever I am. If you never leave me and never forsake me, then you know what? You're right here in this circumstance with me. And I'm just going to ask you for wisdom. And what to do in this circumstance, I'm going to ask you for wisdom. Praise the Lord. And you know what? The Bible says, if any lack wisdom, let him ask of God, who liberally gives it to all men. Liberally. He'll give it to you. He'll give you a lot of it if you'll ask him. If you'll admit I don't have wisdom to know what to do in this circumstance, but Lord, you do. And I ask you for wisdom. Now, I'm going to let your word rule and reign in my life, and I'm going to say what your word says. Because it, the Bible says that God, who quickeneth the dead and calleth those things that be not as though they were, calleth those things that be not as though they were. So, whatever you want to be, you call it according to the will of God. And a lot of people's got